And welcome back once again to Everyman Driver. I'm Dave Erickson. Thanks so much for watching. If you haven't already, please click on that subscribe button. We're uploading between 2 and 3 new videos each week, and I don't want you to miss anything. This week, we're behind the wheel of the 2015 Mitsubishi Outlander Sport. This vehicle was all new in 2011, and except for an updated CVT for better fuel economy, not much has changed for 2015. Now, this vehicle comes in 2 trim levels, ES and SE, and comes in a 5-speed manual transmission in 2-wheel drive or a CVT in 2-wheel drive and all-wheel drive. We have the SE in a CVT with all-wheel drive. Now, we've already done a just-arrived first impressions walk-around of this vehicle. We've also done an off-road review, so today is a driving review. Let's get started first by popping the hood. Our tester features a 2-liter dual overhead cam 4-cylinder engine mated with that CVT. This gets 148 horsepower, 145 pound-feet of torque. And in my opinion, this engine feels a little on the weak side. There's not much in the form of pop. It needs more muscle. My thinking is, if the word sport is in the title, it should be a little sporty, and this is not so much. The estimated fuel economy rating on my tester is 24 miles per gallon in the city and 30 on the highway. Mitsubishi is looking for a mixed number of 27. Unfortunately for us, I think some of this has to do with driving off-road. We've been averaging 20.7 in mixed driving, and we've put well over 100 miles on it so far. On a positive note, the safety rating is basically good across the board with 4-star ratings or better. By the way, the recommended fuel type is regular unleaded. Here's a look at your real-world backseat legroom and headroom. I am 5'11", and this was my position here up front as a driver, and here's how much room I have between my knees and the back of the seat. Not a lot. In fact, my knees are touching the seat back, so leaving much to be desired. I think it's a nice way of saying it. Headroom, a little on the tight side as well, even though you have this panoramic sunroof, which is an upgrade on the Touring trim level. If I sit up straight, my head will be hitting the roof line. You do have a container behind the driver's seat, but not behind the passenger seat. And you do have 4 Oblake handles all the way around. Not the most comfortable back seat, but I guess it's a compact SUV. What are you gonna do? And these are a 60-40 fold-down split with a pair of cup holders here in the armrest. There's only one way to open the lift gate here on my tester, and that's to do it manually. There is no button here on the key fob, and you can't open it from the inside. So just press the button below this Mitsubishi icon after you lock it, and up it comes. Now, the Sport has one of the smaller cargo areas in this class, 21.7 cubic feet of volume behind this back row of seats. Fold them down, you're looking at 49.5 cubic feet of volume. Folding down the back seats is pretty simple. There's a push button here just right of the headset. Press it down and push forward. Same thing, but on the left side of the headset over here, and press it forward. And there you go, 49.5 cubic feet of volume. And just below your floorboard, you have a spare tire and jack kit, just in case of emergencies. When it comes to competition, this is a deep and competitive field. Let me just name off some cars for you. CR-V, Terrain, CX-5, Nissan Rogue, Escape, Renegade, Encore, Equinox, Forester, Trax, Sportage, Tucson, Tiguan, Cherokee, just to name a few. So clearly an uphill battle to get your attention in this very crowded marketplace. Some of the standard interior features on the Outlander Sport for 2015 include a color LCD multi-informational display here in the instrument cluster, steering wheel mounted controls including Bluetooth technology and cruise control. You do have paddle shifters attached to the steering column, not the steering wheel. Speaking of the steering wheel, it is leather wrapped, as is the shift knob. It comes with a 6.1-inch touch panel display audio system here in the infotainment area, but because of our touring package, we have a 7-inch touchscreen. There's also a 6-way manually adjustable driver's seat and premium fabric trim seating throughout. A few of the safety and security features include hill start assist, anti-lock braking system with electronic force brake distribution and brake assist, active stability control, traction control, tire pressure monitoring system, and plenty of airbags to keep you safe. Standard exterior features include super wide high-intensity discharge headlights, auto on and off headlights, fog lights with LED running lights, rear LED combination taillights, side fender turn signal indicators, heated side view mirrors, as well as rain sensing windshield wipers. So the MSRP range here on this 2015 Mitsubishi Outlander Sport is between $20,000 and $25,000. Our tester also includes the touring package, so what you see right here is just under $30,000. I think this is a tough sell on such a competitive marketplace in the compact SUV category. It doesn't have as much cargo room as its competitors. The CVT leaves a lot to be desired. It does have nice ride comfort, and I do like this octane blue color. We'll have much more information on everymandriver.com, and be sure to check out our off-road review of the Mitsubishi Sport. Until next time, I'm Dave Erickson. Thanks for watching.